Hey there, my name is Brian. After years of building apps with Angular, I'm here to help you level up your skills and build better apps. In Angular, understanding the difference between view and content is key to working effectively with components. If you've ever tried querying an element and it didn't work as expected, it's likely because you were mixing these two concepts up. In this video, we'll break down the difference between view and content, and I'll show you how Angular signal queries make accessing both simple and reactive. To start, the view refers to a component's own template, the HTML that is directly inside its associated template markup. This includes all elements and child components that the component itself defines. So everything we see here in the component template belongs to its view. Okay, so that's the view. Now, content is different. Content refers to elements that are passed into a component from a parent using content projection with ng-content. This is considered a slot in an Angular component. In this example, the button tag inside the app card element does not belong to the card component. The card component provides a slot for content, but the content itself within this slot is owned by the parent component instead. The key takeaway here is that the view is part of the component, while content is part of the parent and projected inside ng-content regions. So now that we understand the difference between the two, let's look at how we can access items in each scenario. Let's look at the concept of the component view first. If we want to reference an element inside our component's own template, we use the viewChild or viewChildren signal query functions. This allows us to access elements inside the component's view. They update reactively, so there's no need for the old ng-afterview-init lifecycle hook when using them. Here, we have a simple app card component. It has a heading, a description, and a button. To access this button, we can add a reference variable. This is how we'll target it with our view query function. Now, let's switch to the TypeScript. Here, we can add a new button property. Then, we'll use the viewChild signal query function. We need to be sure that this gets properly imported from the Angular core module too. In this case, we need to type the signal to an element ref, HTML element, since we are querying for the HTML button element directly. And then we just need to pass the template reference from the button as the locator. Next, let's add a button text signal and initialize it to an empty string. Now, let's add a new button clicked method and set the button text signal with the button's text when clicked. Then let's switch back to the template and wire up this function on click of our button element. Then let's add a div and then add the string interpolated value of the signal within it. Okay, now let's test it. Now, when we click the button, we should see the text view button. Nice. So that's how you query elements inside of a component's view. No lifecycle hooks needed, and the signal updates reactively. And just to clarify, if we needed to query for more than one item, we would use the view children signal query instead. Now, to contrast this, if we need to reference content that is projected into our component, not part of the view, we use the content child or content children signal queries instead. This allows us to access elements inside ng content. And just like the view queries, they update reactively when content projection changes, so there's no need for the old ng after content init lifecycle hook when using them. So let's switch the component around a little to demonstrate this concept. Instead of defining the text in the card component template, let's replace the button text with an ng content instead. Let's also remove the reference variable. This now allows us to project content here from the parent when including this component. So now let's switch to the main app component, and let's add a span within the app card selector. Inside this span, let's add the text content button. We'll need to add a template reference variable on it because, like the view child query, we'll use it to reference this element even though it's in the content for our card component now. Next, we can switch back to our card component. Then we can change the view child to the content child function now, since we're referring to the content of the component instead of the view. And we'll need to make sure that it also gets imported from Angular core. Also, we can remove the view child import. Now, when we save and click the button, we should see the content button text now that we've switched the button to the content of the component. And just like the view, if we needed to query for more than one item, we would use the content children signal query instead. So, understanding the view versus content helps us build more reusable, flexible components more effectively. It's an important concept in Angular. Signal queries further simplify things by making it easy to access both view elements and projected content. If you ever run into issues with queries, ask yourself, is the element inside my component's own template? If so, use view queries. Or, is the element projected into my component? If so, use content queries. This simple distinction can save you a lot of debugging time when you understand it properly. All right, we've covered a lot. Now you should have a clear understanding of the difference between view and content in Angular, and how signal queries make working with both simple and reactive. Okay, if you found this helpful, be sure to like, subscribe, and hit that bell so you don't miss the next Angular tip. See ya in the next one.